quite like The Godfather. No, I didn't mind them old rockers, as long as they stayed up on stage. Best of all, though, for me, were the Iron Numbers. They weren't mods, but mods liked them. They smashed up so much gear, nobody believed it was real. I could have done that. In the state I was in, I thought I was all of them. I felt really different the next day. Sleep on the street. I saw one of the Iron Numbers and he shouted, "How you doing?" Like he remembered me. "Working?" he said. I hated it when people said that. Of course I wasn't working, I was still at fucking school. I soon fixed that though. I got myself a job. No, it was dirty, but I was making £10 a week. It's only £2 less than my Uncle Simon, and he's been driving buses all his life.
I'm gonna see.
save them. The blokes I was working with. Poor bastards. Fuck them. Save yourself. They can't leave. They got families to keep. They think the town hall's a cathedral and the mayor's the pope. They deserve all they get. took about 20 leapers at once. Got a first class ticket to Brighton, and I set off to the land of my dreams.
Oh.
I used to think that Brighton was fantastic. The sea looked so gorgeous, I felt I could jump into it and sink. I wandered around thinking about that summer of 64. 2,000 mods driving up and down on scooters. But now I was on my own. It was the end of the season, the place was almost deserted. My poor scooter. That had seen the last of the Brighton promenade.
Mom got a drunk on the stand.
I remembered the ace face dancing. The whole place would be dancing to some stupid dance he just made up. That's powerful, yeah? Why the fuck did I look up to people like that? Why did I need heroes when what I really wanted was to belong? He was like Fred Astaire with a sawn-off shotgun. The ace face, that is. I saw him later that day. For a moment, it cheered me up. He was working in the biggest hotel in Brighton. But he wasn't a fucking manager.
Bleeding heels. You know how I feel.
was in a pretty blasphemous mood by the time I left Brighton. It had cheered me up, but then it had let me down. My folks had let me down. Rock had let me down. Women had let me down. Work wasn't even worth the effort. But I never thought I'd feel let down by being a mod. Schizophrenic! What a laugh! I remember thinking, Christ, it must be all right to be plain ordinary mad. So I stole this tiny little boat with an outboard motor and I set out to sea. here in heaven. I was flowing. I was nearly delirious. I switched off the engine and jumped onto a rock. The music stopped. I remember the come down I had. Felt sick from the booze. The sea was splashing all over the place. There was thunder in the distance. That's how I ended up there. A bleeding boat drifted off and I got stuck on the rock in a pissing rain with my four lives flashing before me. I was an ace face, a tough guy. I was Mr. Jim, a romantic. I was a bellboy. Carry a bag, sir. Finally, I was ordinary old Dr. Jimmy again. Yes, I was those things. Schizophrenic? Ha! I was being quadrupedic. Thank you. Something really big had happened to me. Not an end, not a beginning, but at last I knew what I needed. And I knew where to look for it. Thank you.
play a few things for you. We're very, very grateful that you are thankful that you came to support us with good opinion.
I'm
We're really so glad we brought this, this particular piece, Bonafini, and the stuff that we're doing afterwards. We're so glad we brought it to Germany. It's a long time since we've been here. And as you know, The Who don't sort of officially exist anymore as a recording band, but we got together to do Quadrophenia. And it's been a great experience from start to finish. You might like to know that Roger did a lot of work on the story and on the film and everything else. It's the first time we've worked together creatively, and it's just been great. Also thank the band that were carrying with us. We need these musicians to do this piece, you know, beginning in 73. We recorded Quadrophenia in 1973. And there's no way we could have done this kind of thing with it. Technology just wasn't up to it. But we can do it now, and we need these musicians too. The brass section who cover all of John Emerson's extraordinary work on the record. Percussion and generally keeps us all together. This is a very good friend of mine from way, way back. Met him with the Faces, I think, one of the Small Faces years ago. This is Bill Nichols! On the Kurzweil keyboards, which is all the electronic stuff and the samples and the strings and all that kind of stuff, but also a lot of the sounds that you hear, like the whistling kettle and the sea and all that, is done by this remarkable man, John Kerry! Next to him on piano is someone that's been associated with my solo career and The Who since 1979. And he's another Small Faces connection. He first played with me and Ronnie Lane when we did an album together called Rough Mix way, 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 way back. And 76 that was. And he's still alive. It's amazing, really. He is, in my opinion, the best rock and roll piano player in the world, from Texas, John Rabbit Bundrick! Somebody that's very, very important to me, very glad to be out here, and we really do share the work, as you can see on this, and I can't do it all on my own. There's too much work to do for guitar. This is my brother, Simon Townsend. Tonight, it's always a very difficult chair to fill in The Who. Keith Moon is gone, and it's difficult to replace him. And we've tried many times, and we've had some fantastic drummers working with us, I have to say, over the years. This guy is perfect for Quadrophenia, and it's great to be out with him. He worked a lot with Keith Moon when he was a man. This is Zach Starkey!
Who are you?